Blake Hawthorne, it's his turf. What is up, guys? Today we're gonna be talking about what a lawn care company does in the winter. It's January, and I'm trying to stay busy. Okay, so if you've been following me on Instagram, you've seen all the brush cleanups, the tree work, stuff like that. So, I mean, there is a lot of those services going on. There's a lot of landscape renovations, about to do some big stone makers work, you know, next week. But something that I kind of ventured away from that I was looking back at was my brush cleanups. This is something that I did early on, 2009, 2010, 2011, and I had a lot of really good money in it. You know, one day brush clearings, you know, $550, you know, me and one helper, you know, just basically doing it all by hand. Now that I've got machines, I can tackle a lot bigger jobs. But you know, that was something that I've kind of ventured away from. We've been so busy the last few years chasing all these different things that I thought of, well, I'm teaching you guys through the playbook. I'm showing you how to do it on a small scale with your business. I've done a downsize from 32 employees down to 11 right now. But you know, it's been different, but I've really been thinking about what we can do as a company to still continue to move along, capitalize, make good profits, not get into a winter fund, and just continue to execute and just truck along. So we looked at what we did back in the early years, you know, when we were grinding away. The first thing was firewood. I said, no, not doing firewood. I had to split it by hand. It wasn't fun. I don't want to do it again. So the next thing was the brush clearing. A lot of tree work, a lot of brush clearing. That's what we did early on. We got away from tree work because of the liability and because of our workers' comp. It just got so expensive. So we had increase in insurance on our general liability and in our workers' comp. I axed that, but now we've been doing teamwork with Paul DiGiacomo, Humble Trees. That's been huge for us. And he's actually been landing us these really good brush clearing jobs once again. And man, we're loving it. My guys are really enjoying it. Feels like the early days again. It's great. And so I just, you know, that's something that you guys should be out there looking for and selling. It's something that you can just put a brush blade on your weed eater. That's how I used to do it. And just go out there and clear, you know, lops, maybe a little chainsaw, maybe not. Pile the stuff up or haul it off, you know, whatever. I don't recommend burning it. One time I almost had an uh-oh and I dug a fire ring around the fire. And we covered it in dirt after it had all burned up. High winds came in, flipped that dirt over, pulled some embers, jumped our 10-foot fire ring, and we ended up burning up like 3 acres. God was very much a part of that because it burnt like a perfect ring around the propane tank, down the edge of the building, and on around. It did put a bunch of little bitty holes in the pool cover, so I had to buy like a $3,000 pool cover. That sucked. And then there was like one piece of melted siding, so I had to replace that. But you can, you know, leave that to the customer. If they want it cleared, have them burn it. I just don't recommend that you take that liability as I'm burning on my other job. But I've got 3 pieces of equipment out there. We've had a ton of rain. My fire rings are a little different than they used to be. And we can keep it contained a lot better. Just get out there, do some clearing. It's some great money. I mean, it's even like this right in front of me. See that privet on a property, and you just go to the customer and you talk to them about cleaning that up, because one, it's gonna get snakes and chiggers away from the house, so the more that you can clear the brush away from the house, the better. It just makes it look nice and clean. I always do rule of thumb. I tell my guys, size of your arm and bigger gets left, and then everything smaller gets taken out, and that's just kind of how we do it. And then also we look for things like dogwood trees and other maples that are nice trees, and we just try to take out all the scrub brush. But it's great money, guys. So out there this time of the year, don't let your business slow down and you start getting into your savings or your fund. Keep trucking along, getting your name out there. Let people see your trucks on the road doing work. Make sure they're marked well and get out there and start doing stuff like brush clearing, leaf cleanups. Just get your name out there, get your face in front of people. And then here in a month, you can follow that up and you can start putting out your door hangers, trying to land your lawn care work. Do a follow up in March with your lawn maintenance. So that way they'll get a price on their door hanger. They've already seen you around. It'll really go well. But guys, like I said, don't let everything go stagnant. Don't go into hibernation this winter. You know, really push for those brush clearing jobs, just the cleanups in general. Be looking for things like debris on the roof, leaves in the yard, brush on the, you know, in the property, on the property lines, cleaning those up. That stuff's huge, and they're good tickets to go ahead and go sell and get your name out there. And then, like I said, next month, follow it up, be in those same neighborhoods again with your door hangers, leaving them a price for the lawn work so that way they've thought about you twice now. Maybe they'll go ahead and pull the trigger. We charge $35 a man hour for all of our labor work, hand work, that's lops, hauling brush, etc. $65 a man hour for any time we're going to be running any kind of handheld equipment. And then for our big heavy equipment, we charge $85 a man hour. So I guess that's not a man hour, that's the equipment hour. We charge $85 an equipment hour, you know, that the hour meter's running. And so that's how we've kind of priced these things. We also charge haul offs on our small trailers, 50, on our bigger trailers, 75, and on our, you know, big trucks and big trailers, 100 if they're maxed out. Those are just haul off fees that we figure in. They're good ways to make a little extra money. I know early on, I would try to just cram a bunch of stuff on my trailer throughout the day. So I would just hit each customer like a $25 to a $50 haul off and try to get four or five of those in a day, and then at the end of the day go home, be done, you know, unload the trailer. You know, those are good ways for you guys to kind of push some work this year and line that stuff up. You know, I'm just going back to my roots of what I did years ago. I'm really enjoying it. If you guys got any questions, be sure and leave a comment down below and let me know what you're doing with your business, you know, this time of the year, January and February, to, you know, keep the money rolling, keep everything going, you know, just keeping your name out there. Guys, God bless, have a good day.